So we've had this Tesla Cybertruck for over 6,000 miles in 3 months. And I wanted to give my owner's review so far, having driven it for over 6,000 miles and what we've done to it. Let's get into it. But before we get into my review of the Tesla Cybertruck, having driven it for 3 months now, let's go through what we've done so far. We've got unplugged rims, Cypex wheels with big BF Goodrich tires. We got carbon fiber fenders right here on the front and the rear. The internet's pretty interesting. Half of you feel like love it and the other half don't really like the carbon fiber fenders. I love it. I think it really adds a nice aggressive look to the Cybertruck. I guess it's already pretty aggressive. On top of that, we've got the rear glass broken sticker. I feel like people love this whenever I go to meets because people freak out. They're like,
the window.
What happened to the window? It's, oh, because it's red?
No, on the other side.
What's going on back here?
You actually broke the window. It looked like you did. You tried the same thing over there.
It's fucking hilarious.
Yeah, so what do you think? But it's just a sticker, it's hilarious. And the biggest thing is that it's got a red Genjutsu wrap by TinyBot, but also wrapped by Bespoke Design Lab. The funny thing is that there's like 3 or 4 wrap Cybertrucks that are also red now. A handful of them are in the LA area and then another one across the states. On top of that, the front windshield is tinted and also the sides as well. The biggest update though that was pretty recent is that we did stars in the ceilings. Shout out to the team at Stars in the Ceiling. You can faintly see right now there's stars all over the interior along the roof. But other than that, no other mods. I'm waiting to see what other parts and bumpers and manufacturers come out with stuff that could be added on to the Tesla Cybertruck. But really, that's about it for the Tesla Cybertruck. It sounds like a lot, but at the same time, I guess what's next? Let me know. The 3 things that I really love about this Cybertruck are the comfortability of it. I know that's a made up word, but it's super comfortable. I've said it before in the past and I'll say it again. This is 30% more comfortable than the Model X that we also have. And that's just with the ride quality, the ride height, and also the steering wheel as well, which leads to my second thing. The second thing I really love about the Cybertruck is the steer-by-wire system. Once you get used to it, once you start driving it, it's trippy and you'll really fall in love with it and wish it was on every other Tesla that you own as well. And the third thing that I like is the interior. I really like this interior. It's super comfortable. We've got LED along all around on the side. And I love how there's so much storage space in this Tesla Cybertruck versus any of the other Teslas before in the past. Which kind of leads me to my 3.5 thing. I love the powered frunk. I use it probably the most out of any Tesla just because you don't have to manually push it. You can just push a button, pop open the frunk as easy as peasy and put stuff in it and then close it right away. Those are the 3 things that I really like about the Tesla Cybertruck. But the 3 things I don't like about the Tesla Cybertruck. The first one is kind of an elephant in the room, but it is not the most efficient Cybertruck at all. Watt hours per mile is terrible, and probably real world range is anywhere from 240 to 280 miles of range. The second thing I don't necessarily like, or maybe I'm still getting used to it, is the size of it, which is really not an issue, just something that still I have to be aware about because there's no parking sensors on top of that. I have already hit the Tesla Cybertruck in a weird spot. Maybe one day I'll show you guys. And the third thing, which a lot of people say that they don't necessarily like about the Cybertruck, is the attention. You do have to build in time wherever you go because people are gonna ask about it. So I really just don't like it when I'm in a rush, which it seems to be a lot of my life when I'm rolling around Los Angeles in California. But at the same time, if I've got time, I'll happily let people get into it, sit in it, take pictures of it, because that's what's cool about it, right? Sharing the excitement of the Tesla Cybertruck. But yeah, thank you for watching our 3 month, 6,500 mile update, my quick review on it and what I think about it so far. Let me know if you have any comments or questions down below in the comment section, and I'll see you guys in the next one. See ya. And don't forget to hit that like button as well.